فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
My beloved brothers and sisters, as you're all aware of and you all know, the incident that took place, the atrocity that took place in Somalia not long ago, I think it was a week ago, and approximately 300 people died, 400 individuals injured. I wanted to, inshallah ta'ala, shun some light pertaining to this particular incident. My beloved brothers and sisters, as you're all aware of, and it is from the maqasid of the Sharia, the objectives that the Sharia came to fulfill, is to protect five things. The Sharia, it came to protect ad-deen, the people's religion. And it also came to protect the people's nafs. And it also came to protect the people's aqal, the people's sanity. And it also came to protect the people's honor, their ird. Any individual who has any form of knowledge or even understands what Islam is about, has sniffed any knowledge of it, will know killing an innocent individual, it's haram in our Sharia. And not only is it haram, it's from one of the greatest sins in the religion. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Quran, وَمَنْ يَقْتُلْ مُؤْمِنًا مُتَعَمِّدًا. Any individual who kills a person deliberately, he chooses to do it deliberately, فَجَزَاؤُهُ جَهَنَّمْ. The hellfire will be his abode. خَالِدًا فِيهَا. He will stay in there forever. وَغَضِبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ. Allah has become angry with that individual. وَلَعَنَهُ. And Allah has distanced him from his mercy. وَأَعَدَّ لَهُ. And Allah has prepared for him عَذَابًا. A punishment. عَظِيمًا. That is great. Anyone who just reads that ayah alone will realize the severity of killing one individual. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what does He have promised for you? جَهَنَّمْ. خَالِدًا فِيهَا. وَغَضِبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَلَعَنَهُ وَأَعَدَّ لَهُ عَذَابًا عَظِيمًا. Just one person. Imagine if you come the day of judgment and it's on your neck 300 people that you have killed, women and children. Until today we speak, bodies are still being found. Family members can't even recognize their own women and children. A father was shown his son and he recognized part of the body and said, yes, this is my son. I know him based on his teeth, or I know him based on his fingers. This is my son. People were going crazy, ya ikhwati al-kiram. What will that person who did it, or the person who planned it, or the person who played a role in it, what will they say amam Allah ta'ala the day of judgment? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Quran, قُلْ تَعَالَوْ. Say to them, Muhammad, come forward. أَتْلُ. I am going to recite on you. مَا حَرَّمَ رَبُّكُمْ. That which your Lord has prohibited from you. أَلَّا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. The first of it is not to associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the second is وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. To be dutiful towards your parents. وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا أَوْلَادَكُمْ. And do not kill your children. مِنْ إِمْلَاقٍ. Fear of feeding them. نَحْنُ نَرْزُقُكُمْ. We are the ones who are going to provide for you and your children. وَإِيَّاهُمْ. وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الْفَوَاحِشِ. Don't come close to zina. مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا وَمَا بَطَنْ. That which is apparent and that which is hidden. وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا النَّفْسِ. And do not kill a soul. الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهِ. That which Allah has prohibited from you subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ. Except that which has been made lawful. ذَلِكُمْ وَصَّاكُمْ بِهِ. This is what your Lord advises you regarding. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعَقِلُونَ. So the person can use their mind and ponder and think over what their Lord is saying. وَلِذَلِكَ. Some of the mufassirin, they said that the person who kills an innocent person, لَا عَقْلَ لَهُ. He has no aql. He's not thinking with his mind. And we say to those individuals who killed, وَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ اللَّهَ غَافِلًا عَمَّا يَعْمَلُ الظَّالِمُونَ. إِنَّمَا يُؤَخِّرُهُمْ لِيَوْمٍ تَشْخَصُ فِيهِ الْأَبْصَارِ. Never think to yourself that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is heedless a split second of what those oppressors and those wrongdoers did. إِنَّمَا يُؤَخِّرُهُمْ Allah is delaying it for them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. A day in which He wants to destroy them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grab them, and the day He grabs them, He will destroy them if they don't repent from what they did. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He told us the characteristics. From the righteous people, Ibadur Rahman, Allah said about them, وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَدْعُونَ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا آخَرٍ They do not associate partners with Allah. وَلَا يَقْتُلُونَ النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ And they don't kill innocent people. You don't see them jumping to killing innocent people. How is it a person who learned Islam, who knows the religion, that people are scared of? Many years ago, 2 to 3 years ago, I visited and I met an old man. He said, I never thought I would live a time where I'm scared of a man who has a beard. I'm scared that he might kill me. And that a man who smokes, in my heart, I find safety. He said, one day I was in an alley, I was walking. And he said, in front of me came a man who had a beard. And when he came, I got scared that he might do something to me. And then he brought out a cigarette and he started to smoke, and I became happy and I said, Alhamdulillah, he's not going to kill me. This is how it's become. The people see the Muslim who's practicing and connect them to these evil actions. When this has nothing to do with Islam, لا من قريب ولا من بعيد. It's nowhere and nowhere close or far does it have anything to do with Islam. Rather, I say to you, my beloved brothers and sisters, the people who suffer from the consequences of these people's action are the Muslims, number one. And I'll tell you where it started from. The noble companion, Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And this statement you can find, or this story, in the Musnad of Imam Ahmad and Abu Dawud in his Sunan, and Sheikh Nasir authenticated it in his Silsila Hadith Sahiha. Uthman, he was under siege in his own house. As Abi Umama ibn Sahal and Abdurrahman, Abdullah ibn Amir al-Rabi'ah, he said that we came to Uthman in his house whilst he was under siege. وَهُوَ مَحْصُورٌ فِي الدَّارِ We entered onto him, and then Uthman came out and he said to them, إِنَّهُمْ يَتَوَعَدُونَنِي These individuals, these rebellious individuals, they are promising and they are making an oath, بِالْقَتْلِ To kill me. That's what they want to do. They want to kill me. And so then, Umamah ibn Sahal, he said, we said to Uthman, يَكْفِيكَهُمُ اللَّهُ شَرَّهُمْ May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala suffice you from the evil, ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, the leader of the believers. And then Uthman said, وَبِمَا يَقْتُلُونَنِي Why are they killing me? Why do they want to spill my blood? Ya ikhwa, Uthman has been promised Jannah alive. He's walking on this earth and he knows he's going to enter Jannah. What else can he be promised? Uthman radiallahu anhu said, Why are they going to kill me for? إِنِّي سَمِعْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يَقُولُ I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, La yahillu damru muslimin illa bi'ihda thalath. Al-thayyibu al-zani, wal-nafsu bil-nafsi, wa-tariku li-deenih, al-mufariku li-jama'ah. I heard the Prophet of Allah say that the blood of a believer is not permissible except 3 times. And it can only be done by a leader, a Muslim leader. And he mentioned the 3 times. And then Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, Wallahi, by Allah, ما أحببت I have never liked in my heart أن لي بديني بدلا منذ هداني الله Since the day Allah guided me to Islam, I never ever wanted to leave Islam. ولا زنيت في جاهلية I have never fallen into adultery before Islam and not even after Islam. ولا قتلت نفسا And I have never killed an individual. فبما يقتلونني Why are these individuals willing to kill me? And so they killed Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu in his own house. Uthman was fasting that day. Uthman radiallahu anhu was reading Quran. And so his blood, it fell on the mushaf in which he was reading from. These individuals' action, the Muslims are the first who suffer from it. They deceive the people and they make the image of Islam look bad. Ya ikhwati al-kiram, killing a person unlawfully is one of the things Allah hates, subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَبْغَضُ النَّاسِ إِلَى اللَّهِ ثَلَاثَةٌ Three types of people are most hated to Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first is مُلْحِدٌ فِي الْحَرَمْ A person who is deviated in the sacred land, Makkah and Medina. And some of the scholars, they said everywhere. وَمُبْتَغٍ فِي الْإِسْلَامِ سُنَّةَ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ And a person who wants to bring into Islam that which was from the action of jahiliyyah. وَمُطْلِبٌ And another person, وَمُطَلِّبٌ, a person who is looking for دَمُ مْرُؤٍ, the blood of a person بِغَيْرِ حَقٍ, unlawfully لِيُهْرِيقَ دَمَهُ, he wants to spill the person's blood unlawfully. This person is from the three people Allah hates, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِذَلِكَ, the messenger said, لَنْ يَزَالَ الْمُؤْمِنُ فِي فُصْحَةٍ مِّن دِينِهِ مَا لَمْ يُصِبْ دَمًا حَرَامًا, that a person remains in liberty regarding his religion, مَا لَمْ يُصِبْ دَمًا حَرَامًا, as long as he does not spill blood unlawfully. Abdullah ibn Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه, he said, إِنَّ مِنْ وَرَطَاتِ الْأُمُورِ الَّتِي لَا مَخْرَجَ لِمَنْ أَوْقَعَ نَفْسَهُ فِيهَا سَفْكَ الدَّمِ الْحَرَامِ بِغَيْرِ حِلِّهِ. Abdullah ibn Umar, he said, from the evil deeds which have severe consequences, التي لا مخرج, which there is no way out of it, لمن أوقع نفسه فيها, if a person throws himself into it, is what? سفك الدم الحرام, spilling a blood that is unlawful for you. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, in the hadith Abdullah ibn Mas'ud narrated, أول ما يقضى بين الناس يوم القيامة في الدماء, the first thing that the people would be judged between themselves is the blood. The messenger also said, وَإِلَكُمْ, destruction be for you, لَا تَرْجِعُوا بَعْدِي كُفَّارًا يَضْرِبُ بَعْضُكُمْ رِقَابَ بَعْضٍ, don't turn to being disbelievers after me killing one another. The Prophet referred to killing a person unlawfully, an act of kufr. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud also said that the messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, سباب المسلم فسوق وقتاله كفر, insulting a Muslim is transgression and killing him is kufr. And now we find a person who believes by killing innocent people he will get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How much can shaytan deceive you? Ubadah ibn Samit radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من قتل مؤمنا, anyone who kills a believer, فَاعْتَبَطَ, and he rejoices over it and does not repent from it. بِقَتْلِهِ, so he rejoices, he comes on the radio and he says, Alhamdulillah, we were behind this action, and he rejoices it. لَمْ يَقْبَلِ اللَّهُ, Allah will not accept from him, صَرْفًا وَلَا عَدْلًا, Allah will not accept from him any obligatory act, nor will he accept from him any voluntary act which he comes with. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد, our messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he went on a high place in Medina, and when he went on this high place, he صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, إني أرى, I see الفتن, I see trials and tribulations, خلال بيوتكم كمواقع القطر. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, I see the fitna coming down and entering into your households, just like the rain when it comes down, it goes on the ground. So the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he made sure that he left his companions upon clarity. So one day he came, he led the salah. When he led the salatul fajr, he finished, he stood up, he told the people, he spoke to them. Then dhuhr came, and then he led dhuhr again. And then he stood up again and he spoke. And then he led Asr. And then the Prophet turned around. And then he spoke to the companions. And then Maghrib came. And the Prophet ﷺ did the same. He stood up. Every prayer he was talking all through that, alayhi salatu wasalam. And the narrator, he said, حَفِظَهُ مَنْ حَفِظَهُ, the one who memorized what the Prophet said that day memorized it. And the one who forgot it, forgot it. But the Prophet told them everything they needed to know. And one of the things that the Prophet told us is, إِذَا وُضِعَ السَّيْفُ فِي أُمَّتِي, if the sword is unsheathed, it's taken out and it's placed on the people, لَمْ يُرْفَعْ عَنْهَا إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ, it will not be taken from them until the day of judgment. Since the day the blood of Uthman spilt, The killing has been consistent and it will be going on. وَلِذَٰلِكَ the Sahabas understood that. And so what did they do? They ran away for their religion. They did not participate in anything to do with it. They didn't speak about it. They didn't indulge a word with it. Rather, they ran away. Some of them, they ran away and they went to the outskirts. And that's where they resided. Such as Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu ta'ala anhu, because he heard the Prophet say, يُوشِكُ أَن يَكُونَ خَيْرَ مَالِ الْمُسْلِمِ غَنَمٌ يَتْبَعُ بِهَا شَعَفَ الْجِبَالِ وَمَوَاقِعَ الْقَطَرِ يَفِرُّ بِدِينِهِ مِنَ الْفِتَنِ. There will come a time that what the best thing for a person is, that they run away, they go to the outskirts, they just look after their livestock, and they run away from the city and those who are around it. وَلِذَلِكَ أَبِي سَعِينِ الْخُدْرِي. When the fitna happened and it occurred, he ran away. And so he saw his son Abdullah walking towards him, and his son Abdullah participated in the fitna and he took a role in it. So when he saw him, he said, this evil individual is coming towards me. That's his own son. And when he came to him, his son said to his father, Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, people are fighting over leadership. They're fighting on who's going to be next in charge. And you're here in the outskirts, going with your goats and your camels. And he said, I heard the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say that the best believer to Allah is al-abdu al-taqi al-ghani al-khafi, the slave who is pious, who is rich, and who is hidden from the people. And the Sahabas, not only him, Salamat ibn al-Aqwa, when he was informed of the death of Uthman and he found out, he ran away from the city of Medina and he went and he stayed in a place where it was called Al-Rabda. He married a woman from there. She had a child for him and that's where he resided. And the day in which he died, he was taken from it. Abdullah ibn Umar, Marwan ibn Hakam came to him and he said to Abdullah ibn Umar, Ubayi'uk, I'm going to give you a pledge of allegiance, Abdullah. Abdullah said, on what? Marwan said, I have all of the people of Sham behind me and they are going to give you bay'ah. He said, what about the people of Mashriq? Are they with you? He said, no, they're not with me. He said, what are you going to do with them? He said, kill them. Abdullah ibn Umar said, 70 years for leadership to be in my hands, for me to be in charge for 70 years, and for one blood of a believer to be spilled, I won't accept that. And I'm not going to give bay'ah to you. And I don't want anything to do with that. And Abdullah ibn Umar turned away from that. Al-Ahnaf ibn Qais, he was walking towards the battle of Siffin. So he took his sword from his house and he made his way towards supporting Ali ibn Abi Talib. And on the way, as he was walking with his sword, he saw Abu Bakr Nufay ibn Harith al-Thaqafi radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Abu Bakr said to Ahnaf ibn Qais, where are you heading? He said, I'm heading to help the cousin of the messenger, Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He needs my help. He said, I heard the Prophet of Allah say, إِذَا الْتَقَى الْمُسْلِمَانِ بِسَيْفَيْهِمَا. If the Muslims meet one another with their swords, the killer, al-qatil, and the maqtul, and the one that is being killed, both of them are in the hellfire. And the companions, they said, Ya Rasulullah, the one that is killing, we understand why he is in the hellfire. But why the one who's been killed? Because the Prophet then said, إِنَّهُ كَانَ حَرِيصًا عَلَى قَتْلِ صَاحِبِهِ. He was striving to kill his brother as well. Ya إِخْوَةِ الْكِرَامِ. Spilling blood has nothing to do with our religion. Now that this calamity and this atrocity has happened, there's something that is needed from us. Ya ikhwati al-kiram, any of you who Allah has given wealth, Allah has given them money, and they have, give. The wealth that you have is something Allah gave to you, and He's going to reward you for giving it. Give it before there comes a time when you will wish to give that wealth out. Help those who are in need. Some of the individuals, they've lost their husbands and their wives and their children. What you can do today to help them go through their hardship is to help them financially, inshallah ta'ala. And it's definitely to make dua for them. Allahumma ighfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala al-qawmi al-kafirin. Allahumma ighfir lana hazlana wa jiddana wa khata'ana wa amdana wa kullu dhalika indana ya rabbal alameen. اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا. ربي آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأقم الصلاة.